Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we will discuss about what is list interface, and we'll also discuss about all implementation classes of list interface. These classes are vector, array list, linked list and stack. So today in this video we will cover this one. So okay, let's start discuss about list interface. As we know, list, it is the child interface of collection, and if we want to represent a group of individual object where insertion order is preserved and duplicates are allowed, then we should go for list interface. And here insertion order will be preserved by means of index, and here in the list index play very important role. And these are the methods provided by list interface. First one is add, and we can add element based on its index value. And add all, remove, get, set, index of, last index of. And we will use all the methods. So first we will create one program, and we will create the list interface object by using its implementation class, that is ArrayList. Then we will use all these functions. So now we will discuss first implementation class of interfaces, that is ArrayList class. So first we will discuss about ArrayList, then we will use these all the functions that is provided by list interface, and we'll show the output. And these are the four implementation classes that are implementing the list interface. First one is ArrayList, LinkedList, vector and stack. So first we will discuss about ArrayList. The underlying data structure for ArrayList is resizable array, and the insertion order is preserved in ArrayList, and duplicate objects are also allowed, and heterogeneous objects are also allowed, and null insertion is also possible in ArrayList. And these are the three constructors used by ArrayList class. First one is ArrayList AL is equal to new ArrayList, that is with zero parameters. And it is used to create an empty ArrayList object with its default initial capacity is 10. And once the ArrayList reaches its maximum capacity, then a new ArrayList object will be created. And the formula is new capacity is equal to current capacity into 3/2 + 1. And the second is ArrayList AL is equal to new ArrayList, that is with initial capacity. So this constructor is used to create an empty ArrayList object with the specified initial capacity. We can specify any capacity to this ArrayList object. And the third one is ArrayList AL is equal to new ArrayList collection C. This constructor is used to create an equivalent ArrayList object for the given collection object. Okay, let's start to create one program, and we will use these all constructors and the functions provided by ArrayList class. This we will use in our program. Okay, so first I will open Eclipse. So here I have created one class, that is test class, and inside test class we have declared one method, that is main method. So now what I will do, here I will create one object of ArrayList, and we'll use all the functions and its constructor. So first I will use its first constructor, that is without any parameter, and we'll check its default capacity of ArrayList object. And there is no direct way to check the capacity of ArrayList object. So what we will do here, we will use its all methods that we have shown here. So we will use add method, add all, remove, get, set, index of and last index of. So first what we will do, we will add one object into our array list object. So here we will add the object into object. So here we will add some name, Karan. And now we can check the size of this object. So here the size will be 1 because we have added one object into our array list object. And array list have already implemented toString method to return its content directly in the following format. And as we know, we can store heterogeneous object in our array list. So here we can add also integer value is also heterogeneous, means we can add different type of objects like integer, string, anything we can add. So now I will run this. So here we can see its size is 2, and here I will print array list. And here we can see the value of array list object current and 10 because array list support heterogeneous data storage. And insertion order will be preserved and duplicate will be allowed in array list. So here I can add current again, then it will allow to add the duplicate name. And insertion order will be same. First will be the current, second current, then 10. So here insertion order is preserved. And duplicates allowed, heterogeneous object allowed, and null insertion is also possible. So we can also add null value. So here if I will add al.add null, then it will not show any compile time error or any other error. It will run just like a simple program. So here we can see null is also allowed. So we can also add null value. Like this, we can use other methods, add int index object of, and remove function we can also use. If we want to remove any value from this object, then we can use al.remove. So here we need to just pass the index value from which index we want to remove. So if we want to remove from 0th index, then it will remove first current that will be removed. So here we can see only single current is printed on console. So this was the output. Like this, we can use other functions to get the object based on its index value, and we can set the object based on its index value. Here we need to pass the index number, and here we need to pass the value of object. Like this, we can use all the functions. And ArrayList class also implements random access interface so that any random element we can access with same speed. And the next one that we will discuss is linked list. And in linked list, the underlying data structure is double linked list. And in linked list, insertion order is also preserved and duplicate objects are allowed, and we can store heterogeneous object, and null insertion is also possible. So here everything is like linked list, but here internally data structure that is used is double linked list. And linked list also implemented serializable and clonable interface, but linked list not implemented random access interface. So it is a worst choice if we want to retrieve the object from list. And these are the two constructors used by linked list. First one is used to create an empty linked list object, and second one is used for interconversion between objects. If we want to convert array list into linked list, then we can use this constructor. And these are the methods that is specific to linked list, that is add first, add last, remove first, remove last, get first, and get last. So here now I will go here and will create one linked list object. Linked list object. And here if you want to get first element from this list, then we can use the function add get first. So no need to specify any index, we can directly get the first object, that is al dot get first. So it will return value that is kern. So now I will run. So here we can see the output on console, kern, that is the output. So here we are getting first element from the linked list object, and if we want to get the last object, then we can use its function al dot get last. So it will return the last one, that is null. And like this we can use its other function remove first if we want to remove first object, and remove last if we want to remove the last object from the linked list. Then we can use these functions also. This is used for to add first, this one will be used to add last object. Okay, then the next what we will discuss, that is so after linked list, third one is vector. Vector class is also implementing list interface. Array list and vectors both are the same option. So if we are using vectors, then it will perform the same operation, like the underlying data structure is also same for vector and array list for both. And insertion order is also preserved in vector, and duplicate objects are allowed, heterogeneous objects are also allowed, and null insertion is also possible. And then what are the difference between vector and array list? Inside vector, each method is synchronized, so it provides thread safety, but in array list, this does not provide any thread safety. So if we want to use thread safety, then we can use vector. Otherwise we can go for array list. The both the classes have implemented the same interfaces like serializable, clonable and random access interface. So both are good if we want to fetch the data from any object. If our frequent operation is retrieval, then we need to go for this. And these are the four constructors provided by vector class. First one is vector v is equal to new vector. This is used to create an empty vector object with the default initial capacity will be 10. And once the vector reaches its maximum capacity, a new vector object will be created with double capacity. For example, if its default capacity is 10, and when it will be reached up to 10, then its next capacity will be 10 multiplied by 2 is equal to 20. So the next constructor is vector v is equal to new vector, that is used to define the capacity of vector object. And the next one is vector is equal to new vector initial capacity, and we can also add incremental capacity, means when the vector reaches up to its maximum capacity, then it will provide the increment that we will provide here. For example, its default capacity is 10 that we have defined here, and incremental capacity we have defined 5. When it reaches up to 10, then automatically its capacity will be increased by 5, means new capacity will be 15, and then 20, 25, like this will be the increment. And the next one is vector v is equal to new vector collection c. If we want to convert any collection object into our vector, then we can use this constructor. And these are the methods that is specific to vector class. Add element means we can add element by using this function, and remove element at if we want to remove the element from any index, we can provide the index value and can remove the element from the vector. And this is used to remove the all elements. And element set, if we want to check at fifth index which object is available, then we can use this function. And here we will create vector object. We can also use the same methods add function that is provided by collection, that is the root interface. And we can also use these methods are specific to linked list, so these are showing error now because we are using here vector class, not linked list class. So here I will call the function that is add remove all elements. So here I will just call single function al dot remove all elements. So now all elements will be removed from the vector object, so it will not print, just removing. And what will be the size after removing all elements from vector object? Its size will be 0 and list and vector object will be empty. So here we can see size is 0 and object is empty. And the next one is stack, and stack, it is the child class of vector class. It is a child class of vector class. Stack contains only one constructor, that is zero parameterized constructor. So we can create just empty stack object. And these are the methods that is specific to stack class. And this is object push function. If we want to insert an object into the stack, then we can use push. And object pop is used to remove and return the top of the stack. And the next one is peek, that is used to return the top of the stack object. And the next one is empty, return the true when stack is empty, otherwise false. And the next one is int search, it will use to return the offset from the top of the stack if the object is available. If object is not available, then it will always return -1. So here now what we will do, here we will create one object of stack now here we will remove this one. So here we will use stacks related functions like st dot push function, that is used to insert the object. So here I will add one name, here we can print this stack value. Stack always follow LIFO, last in first out. If you want to use the order last in first out, then we can use stack. Now I will run this, and here what we will do, we will see the output on the console, kern. So here we have printed 2 times. Now I will remove this one. And the second function is pop, that is used to remove and return the top of the stack. So it will remove the object if I will call st.pop. So it will remove the object from the top, but we have only single object, so it will remove this one, and the stack object will be empty print. So here we can see it just removed the top of the stack. And if I will print here, now it will remove and print the object that these have removed. So here stack have removed kern. So here we can see on the control the object value is printed. And the next one is peek, that is used to return the top of the stack. So here we will use peek function, st.peek, it will just remove and not print the value. And now our object will be empty because it will remove the object from the top. It will not remove, it will just get the object from the top of the stack. So stpeek is used to get the object from the top. The next one is used to check the empty object. Here if the object is empty, then it will return true, otherwise it will return false. Now here our object contains one value, so it's returning false. And the last one is int search. So here I will search for the object into stack dot search, and here I will pass the value that is kern. If it is available, then it will return its index. So here what it will do, here we need to print it, that is st.search and here it's printing the index is 1 if the object is not available, and then it will always return minus 1. Here it's returning the value that is minus 1. Okay, so we have covered all the implementation classes for list interface. Okay, thanks for watching this video. In the next video, we will discuss about set and its all implemented classes. Thanks for watching this video.